Yesterday we have completed our AES, DES, symmetric key encryption algorithm, right? So today we have to now start with asymmetric key cryptography. There are two type of the traditional cryptography system, that is symmetric and the asymmetric. In symmetric, we have discussed a lot of things like mode of operation, as well as we have discussed a few algorithms, right? Then now today we have to start with asymmetric. Now asymmetric means we already know the difference between symmetric and asymmetric. In asymmetric, we use two different keys. If you remember, we use two different keys. One is for encryption, another one is for decryption. One will be used by the sender, one will be used by the receiver. But in symmetric key, there is only one key used. Only one key will be used, which is already shared in between the sender and the receiver by using some of the method. That method also we are going to discuss in upcoming sessions. But here in this asymmetric key, to encrypt any data or to decrypt any data, two different keys are available in the entire process. Okay. So whenever we are saying, suppose this is the A system, this is the B system. If this A user wants to send any data to the B, and if that data has to be encrypted, then that data will be encrypted by using the B's public key. See, remember, whenever the asymmetric key or asymmetric method is applied, always remember there are two different keys will be used. Those different keys are called as, one is the public key, one is the public key, and the another one is the private key. Okay, in asymmetric method, public key and the private key will be used. Now, also remember, whenever we are using any method, any algorithm to encrypt the data, if we are encrypting by using any one particular key or any public key of any user, suppose if I'm saying, I am encrypting the data by using the public key of a user. Public key of a user. Then always remember, it should be always decrypted by the private key of a user only. Are you getting my point? If you are encrypting the data by using the public key of a, then you can only decrypt that data by using the private key of that a only. Okay. You cannot use here. First, I will explain ki kaisa hota hai. Ki if A wants to send the data to the B user, and if the data has to be encrypted, then A will encrypt that particular plain text by using the public key of B. Encryption will be done. Encryption will be done by using the public key of B. If A user wants to send the data to the B user, if the data has to be encrypted, that encryption will be done by using the public key of B. Now, whenever the B will receive the data, if B wants to decrypt that data, then B can only decrypt that received data by using B's private key. B user's private key. ओके okay. अभी मान लो कुछ अगर केसेस अगर हम डिस्कस करेंगे कि इफ एंड वन मोर थिंग दिस पब्लिक की एज द नेम सजेस्ट कि पब्लिक की इज ऑलवेज शेयरेबल मतलब क्या होता है और वी ऑल्सो कैन से दिस इज नोन टू ईच यूजर हु इज अवेलेबल इन द नेटवर्क हु इज कनेक्टेड इन दैट पर्टिकुलर नेटवर्क जो भी नेटवर्क में जितने भी यूजर्स हैं वहां पे जितने भी आपके सिस्टम्स हैं सो दे ऑल नोज द पब्लिक की क्योंकि पब्लिक की क्या होती है अनाउंस्ड ही ब्रॉडकास्ट पब्लिक की विल बी ब्रॉडकास्टेड और बाय एनी हाउ दैट इज शेयर्ड इन बिटवीन ऑल द यूजर्स विच आर अवेलेबल इन दैट नेटवर्क दैट इज द पब्लिक की बट प्राइवेट की ऑफ एनी मशीन और ऑफ एनी यूजर सॉरी प्राइवेट की ऑफ एनी यूजर is only known to that particular user itself. It is not shareable. ओके ये सीक्रेट की ही रहेगा, जिस भी यूजर का प्राइवेट की होगा वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ उसी के पास रहेगा, विच विल नॉट बी शेयर्ड बिटवीन एनी ऑफ द यूजर इन इन द नेटवर्क. ओके सो नाउ व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, इफ दिस इज द केस एंड इफ फॉर इंक्रिप्शन इफ आई विल यूज, सपोज दिस इज द ए मशीन, दिस इज द बी और ए एंड बी यूजर्स आर देयर. If A is going to encrypt by using the public key of A, अगर मान लो A के public key से ही अगर encrypt किया A ने, then how B is going to decrypt that? जिससे हमने encrypt किया है, जिस public key से, जिस user के public key से हमने data encrypt किया है, we have to use that user's private key only. Okay, that user's private key only. अगर हम कह रहे हैं कि इफ ए हैज इनक्रिप्टेड द डेटा बाय यूजिंग द पब्लिक की ऑफ ए, देन द बी हैज टू डिक्रिप्ट दैट डेटा बाय यूजिंग द प्राइवेट की ऑफ ए ओनली. सो वेदर इट इज पॉसिबल? नो, बिकॉज प्राइवेट की इज ओनली नोन टू यूजर्स, इट इज नॉट शेयरेबल. तो ए की प्राइवेट की बी को पता नहीं है, सो बी कैन नॉट डिक्रिप्ट दैट डेटा, राइट? सो ए कैन नॉट encrypt any data by using the public key of itself. वो खुद का use करके encrypt नहीं कर सकता. So this case we cannot use. Okay. Now suppose if I'll say कि A and B if they are using or if I'll say suppose this is the A and this is the B and if I'm saying कि A will encrypt the data. Suppose A will encrypt the data by using the private key of A. Suppose A is encrypting the data by using the private key of A. Then what B has to do while decrypting? Then B has to decrypt the data by using the public key of A. Reverse hoga na operation. Then P ko kya karna padega? Public key of A se share decrypt karna padega. But even apart from this B, बाकी के इन बिटवीन अगर कोई भी यहाँ पे मशीन्स होंगे इन बिटवीन दिस नेटवर्क सी डी हुएवर इज अवेलेबल इन दिस नेटवर्क, दे ऑल्सो कैन डिक्रिप्ट द डेटा. वाई? बिकॉज पब्लिक की ऑफ एवरी मशीन और एवरी यूजर व्हिच इज कनेक्टेड इनटू दिस नेटवर्क इज शेयरेबल बिटवीन ऑल द मशीन्स. वो सबको ऑलरेडी पता है एक दूसरे का प्राय पब्लिक की. सो एनी अदर यूजर्स कैन ऑल्सो डिक्रिप्ट दैट डेटा एंड कैन एक्सेस द डेटा, कैन रीड द डेटा और एडिट द डेटा. ओके सो दिस इज ऑल्सो नॉट द फिजिबल सोल्यूशन कि प्राइवेट की किसी यूजर से करो और पब्लिक की किसी और के यूज करके कोई और उसको डिक्रिप्ट कर. दिस इज ऑल्सो नॉट द फिजिबल सोल्यूशन. सो दिस इज वॉट द प्रोसेस विल ऑकर वाइल वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द असिमेट्रिक की इंक्रिप्शन एल्गोरिदम. इफ टू यूजर्स आर देयर, इफ एनी यूजर वॉन्ट्स टू ट्रांसमिट द डेटा, दैट यूजर विल इंक्रिप्ट द डेटा बाय रिसीवर्स पब्लिक की. By receiver's public key, and whenever receiver will receive that data, it will decrypt the data by using the private key of itself. तो B क्या करेगा? अपना खुद का private key use करके उसको decrypt करेगा. Okay, यहाँ तक समझ में आ रहा है? Public key and private key for encryption, for decryption कैसे होता है? This question can be asked in MCQs as well as in the Viva questions. Okay, so this is a simple or the basic phenomenon of your asymmetric key algorithm. Now let us discuss the next, that is knapsack algorithm. Now in this knapsack algorithm what happens? Okay, before that let me just introduce this knapsack algorithm. This is the very first generated public key algorithm. This is very first generated public key algorithm. And this algorithm was developed by Martin Hellman and Ralph Markel. Markel is fixed naam mein thoda sa confusion hai. Martin Hellman and the Markel, they have developed this knapsack algorithm. So if you know the knapsack problem, kya hota hai knapsack problem? Simply suppose if we have the given weights, कुछ वेट्स अगर दिए हैं, फॉर एग्जाम्पल 1, 6, 8, 15 एंड सपोज 24, 1, 6, 8, 15 एंड 24, दीज आर द गिवन वेट्स. ओके, नाउ द थिंग इज we have to select the numbers from this set such that the total weight should be 30. मतलब ये requirement कुछ भी हो सकता है. We have to achieve the total weight, whatever it is given. I have taken the example 30. So from this set, I have to select the elements such that the addition of these all numbers which I have selected should be 13. For example, suppose if I will select 1, 6, 8 and 15, this will become 30, right? So this is how I'm selecting. To select this set from the given number of weight is the knapsack problem. So by using this concept only, ये knapsack algorithm in the cryptography आया. Now, how we encrypt the data by using such type of the keys? I will just explain. We will see one detailed example in this. How we encrypt the data? Suppose this is my set of key. यही मेरा set of key है. This is the public key. Because by using the public key only, we encrypt the data. Right? Now consider my plain text is 10011, then 11010. This is my plain text. Okay. Now remember, ki whatever the key elements you have, kitne number hai? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 hai na? So set of plain text, matlab your plain text will also be divided into that number of sets. Jitne elements hai, yahan pe 5 hai, toh utne mein hi aap isko divide karenge. Ab, I have taken the example exactly in the set only. अगर इफ यू डोंट हैव द कंप्लीट सेट देन यू हैव टू ऐड द डमी नंबर. जैसे हमने प्रीवियस एग्जांपल्स में भी देखे हुए, एल्गोरिथम्स में देखे, वी ऐड डमी एलिमेंट्स, राइट? लाइक दैट यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर द सेट. नाउ हियर आई हैव 5 एलिमेंट्स, सो आई हैव सिलेक्टेड द 5 एलिमेंट्स ब्लॉक. नाउ व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, सिंपली नाउ 1, 6, 8 and 15 and the 24, दिस इज माई सेट, राइट? सो व्हाट आई विल राइट, आई विल राइट एवरीथिंग 1, 6, 8, 15 and 24. Here also I will write below this 1, 6, 8, 15, 24. अब क्या करना होता है, इसको मल्टीप्लाई करना है. सो वेर एवर यू हैव जीरो, दैट वैल्यू बिकम्स जीरो, राइट? एंड देन आई हैव टू एड द एंटायर वैल्यू. सो 1 into 1 were 1, 6 into 0 0, 8 into 0 0, 15 into 1 15, and 24 into 1 that is 24. So if you add this number, the value becomes 40. Same here, 1 into 1, 6 into 1, plus karna hai isme, plus 8 into 0, that is 0, 15 into 1, and then 24 into 0, that is 0. So if you will add this value, 1 plus 6 plus 15, that is 22. So you have to now concatenate this 40 and 22. This is your ciphertext for this plain text. In this way, we used to encrypt the data by using the knapsack algorithm. Okay. Now, the main thing here is we have to find out the key. How to find the keys? First of all, we have to find the keys ourselves. So, kaise karte hain yahan pe? We know there is two type of the keys we use, public and the private. Right? So in this public and private key, usually there is two methods under this knapsack. One is called as the hard method or hard knapsack, and one is called as the easy knapsack. So isme kya hota hai, we know for public this public key is used for encryption and this private key is used for decryption, right? Public key will be used for encryption, private key will be used for decryption. Now, as I said, easy knapsack and the hard knapsack, ye do types hote hain iske under. And by using the easy knapsack, we first find out the private key for the decryption purpose. Hum kya karte hain, jab bhi hum keys find out kar, we used to find out the keys so that encryption decryption should happen. To sabse pehle by using the easy knapsack we find out the private key, and by using the hard knapsack we used to find public key. Theek hai? Now how we find this private key or what is present in this easy knapsack. Simply in this easy knapsack your weights, whatever the weights are there, jo hum select karne wale na is element, the elements or the weights which we are going to select in the set, those weights are in super increasing order. क्या होते हैं? They are present in the super increasing order. Now, what is mean by super increasing order? For example, 1, 2, 4, 9, 20. Suppose 38. Now, what is the meaning of the super increasing order? Whatever the number you will select from this set, no, the previous number of addition is less than that next number. जैसे मान लो यहाँ पे 4 है, तो 2 + 1, 3, which is less than this 4, right? या फिर आप ऐसा कह सकते हो कि whatever the number summation of this previous number is there, greater than that of summation, your next number will be available. वो number कुछ भी हो सकता है, but that should be summation, summation of that number should be greater. So जैसे यहाँ पे 4 + 2 + 1, 7, right? 9 is greater than 7. 20 is greater than summation of this. 38 is greater than summation of this. So this or this order or this set is called as super. They are present in the super increasing order. Okay. In such type, in super increasing order only, we find out or we select the elements or we select the weights in this set. Okay. To find by using this, we use the private key. मतलब ऐसे इस तरीके से हम लोग private key find out करते हैं. And by using this set, we used to find out the public. अब वो कैसे करते हैं? That let me explain. We'll take one example. Now suppose first I have to select the private key. So that means super increasing order में I will find out the private key. Now D is private key is used for decryption, right? That is why I have write D, that is to find out the private key. Now suppose I will take the key like 1, 2, 4, 10, 20, and 40. 1, 2, 4, 10, 20, and 40. This is in the super increasing order, right? अगर आप summation देखेंगे previous सारे numbers का, next number उसका greater है. Fine. Now after this, we should know the value of n and the m variable. Okay. Now what is this n and the m variable? This n is a multiplier and m is the modulo. हम लोग जो modulo operation के लिए use करने वाले हैं value. This n and m. Now this we have to find. Now how? What should be this m value? This value of m should greater than sum of all the numbers in your in this set. In I will say in D set. Okay, whatever the value you will select for this m ki value jo bhi aap select karoge wo aisi value honi chahiye, it should be greater than the summation of this all number 1 + 2 + 4 + 10 + 20 + 40, whatever the number it will give the result, greater than that we have to select such value. Okay, suppose if I will select here m is 110 60 70 77, so I have selected 110. कोई भी वैल्यू विच इज ग्रेटर देन दिस यू कैन सिलेक्ट एज अ एम वैल्यू. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस एन? दिस एन इज अ मल्टीप्लायर. एन इज अ मल्टीप्लायर. नाउ रिमेंबर व्हेन एवर यू आर सिलेक्टिंग दिस एन, दिस देर शुड नॉट बी एनी कॉमन फैक्टर अवेलेबल इन बिटवीन दिस एन एंड द एम. मतलब ये दोनों क्या होना चाहिए? आई विल राइट हियर, नो common factor with m. You have to select this multiplier such that there should not be any common factor available in between this m and the n. Now suppose if I will select n is equals to 31. Fine. M is 1110. इसका greater than इसका condition बताया. Then n I have selected such that in between this m and n there should not be any common factor. Okay. Now how we are going to find out this e? D we already have for the private. This is the private key for decryption, right? Now we have to find out the e set. No, we have to find out now e. How we are going to find out that? Simply, this element, the element which is available in this D set, this element into this multiplier. Multiplier kya hai? N into this multiplier mod this M. Okay, this is the formula. This is the say this value is from the D set. So if I will calculate for all, that is first value kya hai? 1 into n is 31 mod 110. M ki value 110 hai. If I will calculate for the second value, 2 into 31 mod 110. Next is 4 into 31 mod 110. Next 4 ke baad kya hai? 10 into 31 mod 110. Next 20 into 31 mod 110. Okay, 40 is remaining. 40 into 31 mod 110. Now 31 mod 110 will be 31 into 2 mod 110 will be 62. Then if you will 31 into 4, yahan pe values 14, 90, 70 and 30. Theek hai, this ye output aapko milega if you will calculate. 1 into 31 mod 110 31. Is tarike se ye hame set mila. Now this set of element will be your E set. 31, 62, 14, 90, 70 and 30. Okay, D we have calculated initially. That is the private key. This is in the super increasing order.
Capital or small one?
Chalega. No problem. This is the E. Okay. This is used for encryption. And which is used as a public key. For encryption, we always use public key. And for decryption, we always use private key, which we have in the super increasing order. Or by using this, we have just put these values into this operation. We have calculated element set into multiplier mod M. NNM की कैसे सेलेक्ट करने हैं वैल्यूज वो यहाँ पे बताया. तो ये हमें मिला इंक्रिप्शन का सेट, पब्लिक की का सेट. ठीक है, नाउ हाउ टू परफॉर्म द इंक्रिप्शन. लेट मी कीप दिस हियर. नाउ सपोज लेट मी टेक वन. इंक्रिप्शन करना है मतलब सबसे पहले हमें क्या चाहिए? ई वैली सेट, ई का सेट. 31, 62, 14, 90, 70 and 30, this we want, right? Let me take one plain text. Suppose 100 100 100 100 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 ऐसा कुछ सेट लिया. नाउ एज आई सेड, जो फर्स्ट एक्सप्लेन किया था ना इधर कि कैसे इंक्रिप्ट करते हैं, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फॉर्म अ ब्लॉक. राइट, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फॉर्म अ ब्लॉक. कितने का ब्लॉक करेंगे? जितना इसमें एलिमेंट रहेंगे. सो 1 2 3 4 5 6, टोटल 6 एलिमेंट्स आर देयर. सो आई विल मेक 1 2 3 4 5 6, 1 2 3 4 5 6, 1 2 3 4 5 6. ठीक है, नाउ लेट मी राइट दिस. 1 0 0 1 0, अच्छे 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 sorry 1 0 1 1 1 0. Now simply what we have to do now, whatever the number we have, जहां जहां वन दिख रहा है ना, बस उसी की वैल्यू उसके नीचे लिख दो और उसका समेशन कर दो. जीरो है तो वहां पे तो कोई है उसका कुछ आएगा ही नहीं. सो सिंपली आई विल राइट 31, दिस इज अवर सेट राइट, 31, 62, 14, 90, 70 एंड 30, राइट. सो वेर एवर वी यू हैव द वन वैल्यू, आई विल जस्ट 31 प्लस 90, 31 प्लस 90. हियर 31 प्लस 62 प्लस 14 प्लस 90, 0 0 है सो नो नीड टू राइट द रिमेनिंग वैल्यू. हियर 31 प्लस ये 0 है सो अगेन 14 प्लस 90, 14, 90 एंड 70, ठीक है. सो इसका समेशन क्या आ रहा है, 31 प्लस 90 विल बी 121, 31, 62, 14 प्लस 90, 7, 9, 1, 197, right? Here, 4, 5, 205. Okay? So this is what? This is yours. Calculated value. So you just have to write like this, concatenate. 121, 197 and 205. So whenever we are sending this, this will be sent as a one stream only. But yahan pe teen teen ka block, whenever you are decrypting the value, that time we are considering, we are decrypting individually. Ye jo block wise decryption hua tha, first we are going to convert this into the blocks, into the binary form, and then we are going to decrypt the data, right? But this is our cipher text. Our cipher text is 121, 197 and 205 for this given data, for this plain text. Okay. Now, how we are going to decrypt this? Suppose receiver has received the data. For decryption, first, remember, receiver should always know the value of m and the n, okay, because now we have to find out at the time of receiving, at the time of decryption, we will need this n inverse value. M and n should be known to receiver, that is the condition. M ki value kya thi hamari, 110, and n was 31. Now we have to find out the n inverse at the receiver side, then only we can find out the plain text by using this cipher text. So how we usually find the value, n into x mod 110 equals to 1. We can find the n inverse value, right? So you have to find out the value of x such that when you multiply that value with this 31, and if you will perform the mod 1110, the value should be 1. Yahan pe aap hidden trial method kar sakte ho. Also, you can use to find out the multiplicative inverse, extended Euclidean algorithm. If you remember, वो जो chart बनाते थे, R, R1, R1, R2, R, T1, T2, T, S1, S2, S, ये जो था ना, जिसमें से हम T1 वाले column लेते थे for calculating the extended Euclidean algorithm, S1 वाला, right? So you can use that method also, or you can also find out the value of x simply by hit and trial method. So, filhal, I have already calculated this x value. If you find out the inverse of this 31, this x value will be 71. X value will be 71. Extended Euclidean algorithm. You can use that if you are not getting value like this. So, wo simple padega. 2 minute ka time lagega, lekin usko exact value aa jayegi aapko, theek hai? Then x 71. Now what simply we have to do? Whatever the value here we have. 121, first block kya hai cipher text ka, 121 into this n inverse value, that is 71, okay, mod 110, same second block 197 into 71 mod 110, next 205 71 mod 110. Now, if here also I have calculated 71 into 120 and mod, you will get the value 11. Here you will get the value 70. Here you will get the value 35. Okay, when you will calculate this, the answer will be like this, 11, 17 and the 35. Now, whatever this decimal number you have received, okay, the result which you have, you just have to write it by using these elements. Now, for decryption, which set we use? For decryption, we use the set of D, that is the private key. Private key of the receiver we are going to use. Private key, humne ab kaun si calculate ki thi? This one. Jo super increasing order mein tha. Right? This set we have to use. I will write it here. Our D was 1, 2, 4, 10, 20 and 40. This was the set. Right? Now by using this, 11, 17 and 35 result. Hai na? 11, 17 and 35. Now simply you have to put the values such that you will get the summation 11. Okay? अब जैसे मुझे 11 करना है, so what I will do, 10 plus 1 I can do. So I will write 1 के नीचे 1 and जो भी summation में आप ले रहे हो values, that will be 1 and the remain rest of the values will be 0. So this is 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. So 10 plus 1 will be 11. Okay? 17. 17 का कैसे लेंगे? 10, 4, 2, 1. This will be 17. So 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Okay? Now 20 plus 10, 20 plus 10, 32. Okay, yahan pe haan. So 1, 0, 4, 1, 1, 1, and 0. Okay, so this I have received plain text. So we'll match this one. First block kya mila? 100, 100. If you will compare this. This was my first plain text block. 100, 100. Right? Next. 111100. This was my second block. 111100. Then the third. 101110. Here. 101110. So in this way, we can find out the plain text as well as the ciphertext encryption by applying the method of encryption and for decryption. You just have to remember this knapsack algorithm was invented by the Hellman and your Markel. And this was the first public key algorithm, which was first invented. Okay. And we are going to just simply, first of all, apply the easy knapsack and then the hard knapsack. Easy knapsack will be used for to find out the private key and hard knapsack will be used to find out the public key. Private key used for the decryption, public key is used for the encryption. Now, whenever you are finding out the set by using the easy knapsack, simply what you have to do, you have to find out the weight such that they are in the super increasing order. Super increasing order kya hota hai? Ki next value jo bhi rahegi, usse previous values ki summation se greater rahegi. That is the super increasing order. Fine. Or simply by using that, N and M kaise value select karne hai, wo yahan pe likha, bataya. And then we have formed this encryption set also. Okay, simple hai. Knapsack usually matlab ab tak jaise RSA RSA hoga ya fir AES DES ye sab bataya ki bahut important hai, matlab usme se ek na ek bar in every university examination your questions will be asked. Alternatively matlab is bar AES hai to agli bar DES, DES hai to AES, is tarike se pucha hi jata hai. But knapsack, that is not much asked in the university examination, but you should know the method, the procedure. Can't say ki is paper mein aayega, nahi aayega. Abhi tak to waise poocha nahi gaya. Theek hai? So this is the knapsack algorithm. Now the next is the RSA algorithm. This is very important, we can say, with respect to your university examination, also gate examination. Ispe numericals bahut sare aate hain. कंपलसरी गेट एग्जाम में न्यूमेरिकल आता है, फिर आपकी यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन में फॉर 10 मार्क्स द क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क्ड. एक्सप्लेनेशन इज नॉट यूजुअली आस्क्ड फॉर द आरएसए एल्गोरिथम, बट द न्यूमेरिकल विल बी गिवन एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट समटाइम्स पब्लिक की, यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट समटाइम्स प्राइवेट की, लाइक दैट. ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट इज दिस आरएसए? दिस इज सिंपली वी कैन से व्हाट द डेवलपर्स who have developed this RSA algorithm. From their name's initial, this name has RSA. The developer were Rivest, Shamin, and Adelman. They were the developer, और उनके initial से इसका नाम आया RSA. This was developed in around 1978. As you know, this is, we are discussing under the asymmetric key encryption algorithm. So objectives mein, abhi, now you know ki we are discussing under the asymmetric encryption algorithm, but whenever the question will be asked in the examinations, this is the symmetric or asymmetric, or how many keys will be used, or blocks hote hain ki nahi hote, such type of questions can be asked in the objective. Okay, so as I said, this is the asymmetric key algorithm. Asymmetric है, that means there will be two keys available. One will be public key and one will be private key. Right? Public key is used. Public key is used for encryption or decryption. Public key is used for encryption or decryption.
Encryption.
Yes, public key is used for encryption. Correct. And private key is for decryption. इंक्रिप्शन जिस यूजर के की से कर रहे हैं बाय यूजिंग एनी यूजर्स पब्लिक की इफ यू आर इंक्रिप्टिंग देन यू हैव टू डिक्रिप्ट द सेम कोड बाय यूजिंग द प्राइवेट की ऑफ दैट यूजर ओनली रिमेंबर दिस थिंग फोर ऑप्शंस विल बी गिवन लाइक ए एंड बी आर कम्युनिकेटिंग विद ईच अदर द डेटा विल बी ट्रांसमिटेड फ्रॉम बी टू ए देन हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू इंक्रिप्ट by using the A's key, by using the B's private key, public key, such type of the questions can be asked in the competitive examinations or your UT may be aapke aa sakta hai, theek hai? Encryption and decryption. Now, as I said, this public key is shared between all the users in the network and this private key is always secret key to the user only. Okay, now let us discuss the algorithm for this. Okay, first we will discuss ki how we generate the key in this. Key generation kaise hota hai wo dekhenge. Now, the first step here is we have to select two prime numbers. Now remember, here always the largest prime numbers will be used. Okay, but whenever we are solving the examples, or even if in the examination also, whenever the question will be asked, numericals will be asked, that time these prime numbers will be given less. Matlab, the algorithm itself says we have to select the two largest prime number. बट वेन एवर वी यूज टू सॉल्व हमें कुछ सॉल्विंग करना होता है उस टाइम पे आपको हमेशा ये प्राइम नंबर्स लेस नंबर ही दिए जाएंगे अदरवाइज एक्चुअल में जब इम्प्लीमेंटेशन होता है इन द क्रिप्टोग्राफी वेन वी इनक्रिप्ट द डेटा बाय यूजिंग RSA algorithm दैट टाइम ऑलवेज रिमेंबर देयर विल बी ऑलवेज टू लार्जेस्ट प्राइम नंबर्स वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट एंड दोज वी आर सेइंग लाइक पी एंड क्यू ओके वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट टू प्राइम नंबर्स पी एंड क्यू ध्यान से कॉन्सेंट्रेट करना 10 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन विल बी आस्क्ड फॉर RSA एंड RSA इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट असिमेट्रिक एल्गोरिदम बहुत फेमस एल्गोरिदम है नाउ द सेकेंड स्टेप इज आफ्टर सिलेक्टिंग दिस टू प्राइम नंबर्स नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ n सच दैट दिस n विल बी कैलकुलेटेड बाय p into q okay we have to find out the value of n that will be p into q now next step now we have to calculate the phi of n okay phi of n if you remember this phi of n we have already discussed about this do you remember what is this phi of n what we call kya bolte hain ise kaun sa function which function we call this is Yes, Kaushal, Saili, Atharva, anyone? Which function this is? Phi of n.
Euler's torsion function.
Yes, correct. This is called as Euler's torsion function. This is Euler's torsion function. And if I am saying this n will be calculated by p into q, okay? And this p and q are the prime numbers. So if you remember, in extended Euler's, in Fermat's theorem also, or in the Euler's torsion function also, extended jo humne dekha tha usme, if the value of this n is prime number, if the value of this n is a prime number, then simply what we used to do? That number minus 1 is the Euler's torsion function. If you remember, हमने क्या किया था? अगर prime number होता है तो minus 1, n minus 1 करते हैं, so we will get the phi of n, right? So here we have to find out this phi of n. N is what? P into q. And we know that p and q both are the prime numbers. So we can find out this Euler's torsion function simply by p minus 1 into q minus 1. Why this is p minus 1, q minus 1? अगर याद नहीं आ रहा है तो आपके जो लास्ट सेशन है कुछ उसको रिवाइज करना, आपको याद आ जाएगा. Euler's torsion function में हमने देखा था. If this is a non-prime number, then we have to solve with the given operations, right? जो हमने देखा है उसको solution find out करना. But if prime number है तो usually हम क्या करते हैं, सिर्फ minus 1 करके हमको answer मिल जाता है, right? So p minus 1, q minus 1, you will get the Euler's torsion function. Now after this, this is the basic requirement. You have to find out some values so that you can put into the next calculations. Okay. Now after this, now we have to find out, or we have to choose the value of E. Now E is for encryption. Encryption hai iska matlab public key. Now we have to find out the value of E such that your this E value should be greater than 1. Okay, your E value should be greater than 1. Also, it should be less than phi of n. Phi of n, which we will calculate in the previous step, p minus 1, q minus 1 into, right? So our value of E should be greater than 1 and less than phi of n. Also, there is one more condition, ki kaise select karna hai. GCD of phi of n and E should be 1. This is the condition while we are selecting this public key. Your E should be greater than 1, less than phi of n, as well as we have to also consider GCD of phi of n and E should be 1. Matlab, E and phi of n, jo bhi value hogi, in between both, the common factor should not be greater than 1. Unka common factor ek hi hona chahiye. It should be 1 always. GCD should be 1 always in between these both. So by considering these two conditions, we have to find out, we have to choose, or we have to select the value of E. Okay. Now, the next is the fifth state, we have to find out the value of D. Now here in the fifth state, we have to find out the value of D. Now what is this D? This is used for the decryption. This is private key, right? This is private key used for decryption. This is for the encryption. Now, how we are going to calculate this D? This D value we have to select such that it should be congruent to E inverse mod phi of n. That is, if I will write like this, E into D is 1 mod phi of n. If I want to simplify this, E into D mod of phi of n is equals to 1. Your value of D should be selected such that this equation. जब भी आप उसको मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे विद द ई मॉड ऑफ फाइ एन, इट शुड बी द वैल्यू शुड बी 1. ओके, नाउ वंस यू विल गेट दिस ई एंड द डी, your public key and the private key. Here, this is the sixth step, public key. Then your public key will be E and the N. While we are encrypting, we have to use this set, E and the N. And your private key will be D and N. This E is the encryption key. This is the public key, right? And D jo hai, decryption, private key hoti hai, wo secret key hoti hai. That is only available to the receiver. Fine. Now, I will just repeat this step. While we are solving the example, आपको और थोड़ा सा इसका क्लियर हो जाएगा. सिंपली ट्राई टू रिमेंबर दिस स्टेप. ये स्टेप्स बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. इवन इफ यू आर थिंकिंग फॉर द नेक्स्ट स्टडीज ऑल्सो, तो वहाँ पे भी अगर नेटवर्किंग वाला पार्ट आता है तो उसमें कंपल्सरी RSA algorithm is always available. So in that case also the algorithm will be same ही आपको पढ़ना पड़ेगा. So just remember the steps. दो तीन बार रिवाइज करेंगे आराम से याद हो जाएगा. फर्स्ट स्टेप इज वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट टू प्राइम नंबर्स विच विल बी लार्जेस्ट प्राइम नंबर्स एंड दैट विल बी डिनोटेड एज पी एन क्यू. ओके, द नेक्स्ट इज वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एन, द वैल्यू विल बी पी एन टू क्यू. देन वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द फाई ऑफ एन विच इज पी माइनस वन इंटू क्यू माइनस वन, बिकॉज दिस पी एन क्यू इज द प्राइम नंबर, सो सिंपली वी कैन राइट इन दिस वे. देन आफ्टर दैट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द पब्लिक की ई. This E should be such that greater than 1, less than phi of n, and GCD of phi of n and the E should be 1. This we have to consider while we are selecting the value of E. Then to calculate the D, this is the private key for the decryption. How you are going to calculate the D? Whenever you are finding out the value should give this equation equals to 1. E into D mod phi of n equals to 1. So once you will get the D and the E and the N value, okay, your public key set and the private key set will be ready. Your public key set is E and N, private key will be D and N. Okay. Now remember, whenever any question or the numerical will be asked in the examination, that time one of this key, either E or D, will be given to you. क्या होता है कि whenever the question will be asked, in that question always either E or D will be always given. तो आपको by using that you have to find out the other one. P and Q will be given and directly your encryption or the decryption key will be given and then you have to find out the rest of the thing. अगर private दिया है तो you have to find out the public. If public is given then you have to find out the private. But for that also you need to find out these earlier state. Because we have to find out the n value in both the sessions for both the procedures. So वो n के लिए again we have to go through this all step. ठीक है, तो ये तो हमें करना ही पड़ता है even if given any value. So this is what okay. Let me just write encryption and the decryption formula and numerical we will see in the next session. Now how we encrypt this? I will write here. Encryption. A simple formula. We have to find out the ciphertext, right? By encryption method. So ciphertext can be formed by m rest to e mod n. Now what is this m? Your m will be plain text. Your m will be plain text. A plain text. So मतलब कैसे plain text लिखोगे? For example, मान लो मेरा plain text है hello. My plain text if it is hello, then how many characters are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my m value will be 5. M will be 5. Okay, your m is your plain text. Here you can write p also. So c equals to m rest to e mod n. E ki value we already have here, n value we already have here. So we just have to put the values and plain text will be given, right? To find out the ciphertext. So usme jo bhi characters honge, that will be your m value. So you have to put all the values and you will get the ciphertext. Fine. Now for decryption. Decryption means you have to find out the plain text. Plain text hai matlab m aapko find out karna hai na. यहाँ पे पी ही कर देती हूँ, इजी जाएगा. बट पी यहाँ पे ये फिर कंफ्यूजन हो जाएगा पी और क्यू का. लेट मी कीप दिस एम एज इट इज, एम रेस टू ई. हाँ, देन हियर ऑल्सो हैव टू फाइंड आउट द एम. एम इक्वल्स टू सी रेस टू डी, सी रेस टू डी मॉड एन. We have a cipher text because receiver will receive the cipher text itself. तो उसके जो भी characters होंगे, मान लो कुछ x y z m ऐसा कुछ उसको cipher text मिला है, hello का cipher text अगर x y z m बना है, and then receiver has received. So c's value will be that 5. Rest to d value we will already have, n value we already have. So we just have to put the values and decrypt, and then you will get the plain text. So encryption formula is C equals to M rest to E mod N. Decryption formula is M equals to C rest to D mod N. Okay. And for calculating this or for performing this, we have to solve these steps because we have to find out some values. Okay. So we'll solve two examples in the next session. So the algorithm will be clear to you. 10 marks question will be asked on this. So we'll stop here for today. Mark your attendance. If already marked, you can leave.